welcome back. My name is Jay Clifford, and this is Zero to Hero, a beginner's guide to Loki. In the last episode, we answered a couple of questions about logs: what they are, their origins, and what problems do they solve and create. In this episode, we're going to look a little deeper into how logs are structured. Think about the basic components of a log, formatting types, and standardization. We have a lot of ground to cover, so we're going to split this lesson into two parts. Part one is all about the components of a log. Let's get started. We can imagine log components as the Lego blocks that create a log entry. They are modular, some are necessary, and others are optional, but they build greater context. We will start by breaking each of these building blocks down. In the last episode, we described a log as being akin to a diary for a computer or application. So, what are the key components of a diary that differentiate it from, say, keeping a list of notes about your life? The timestamp. The timestamp anchors our event to a specific moment in time. Timestamps provide us with a huge amount of context. And this is the same for logs. We can use it to compare, contrast, and correlate different log sources and metrics which share a similar timestamp. For instance, the system log is warning us of critically high memory consumption. At the same time, we can see a sharp and climbing trend within our memory usage metrics. This typically indicates a memory leak within one of our applications. We can then jump into our application logs to check for a potential root cause around the same time period. When looking at timestamps within a log, they typically follow the ISO 8601 format and can vary in granularity, anywhere from seconds to nanoseconds. Now, it's not a given that all logs will have timestamps, as you will see in the demo in the next episode, but it is best practice to include one. Next is the logging level, which can also be referred to as the severity level. We can imagine the log level being like signposts along a road. A signpost color and shape usually indicate how important the message is for us to read, and they can typically come in five major flavors. The first and lowest on our list is called debug. Imagine this as the white or informational signposts on a road, indicating non-critical information like historical landmarks or scenic areas. In logging, debug messages are similar. They provide detailed contextual information used during development or troubleshooting. Next on our list is info or information. These are akin to the blue signposts indicating services or facilities, such as rest stops or gas stations. They are informative, but not indicative of a problem. In logging, info messages communicate normal or expected events within our application, like successful initialization or routine operations. About at the middle tier now, we're looking at warn or warning. This is comparable to yellow or cautionary signposts warning of potential hazards ahead, like sharp bends or merging traffic. In the context of logging, warn messages alert to situations that are not errors, but could potentially lead to problems if ignored. For example, deprecation warnings or unexpected system states. They don't prevent operation, but might require attention later on. Next is error. These can be thought of as the orange signposts alerting to more immediate or significant issues that need our attention. Similar to road construction signs, in logging, error messages indicate problems that have occurred which could affect the operation of the application, but might not necessarily halt its functionality. These are issues that require prompt attention, such as failed operations or data processing errors. Last but not least, top of the list is critical. These correspond to the red signposts that demand immediate attention, such as stop signs or wrong way alerts. In the world of logging, critical messages signal severe situations where the application might not be able to continue running. These are the highest priority messages, indicating catastrophic system failures, security breaches, or other critical events that need immediate and decisive action. Log levels are important to remember when we learn how to parse, tag, and ingest logs later with Loki. The final basic component of a log entry is the message itself. This is a human-readable description detailing the event that took place. The contents of this message can vary greatly between log sources. The message might also include identifiers such as user IDs or transaction IDs. Lastly, there are some special credit components to logs. It is worth noting that these are not standard across all logs, but it can improve cross-referencing within log aggregation solutions like Loki. These can include things like event ID. These are unique identifiers of the type of event being logged, such as an API exception. Another could be source or component. Commonly found in distributed systems, these identify the application or systems that generated the log entry. Context information, this is mostly metadata, which can help with post-event debugging. Think about the state of the system and the values of the relevant variables at that time. And last but not least is trace ID. This could be linking a log to a specific transaction between systems within a microservice architecture. We aren't going to dive too deeply here yet, as this can muddy the water between tracing and logs. We will cover this potentially in another video. Let's quickly recap what we learned in the lesson today. You can imagine log entries like a Lego set, and the components like blocks. Some of the blocks are more necessary than others, such as the timestamp, severity level, or message. Then some are optional but provide a more detailed overview of our application or system, such as state, source, event type, or trace ID. In part two of this lesson, we will cover how these building blocks can be assembled together and represented to the user. Until next time, make sure you check out our Grafana for Beginners series and the previous episode, Intro to Logging. My name is Jay Clifford. Thanks for watching. Stay curious.